Hello students, today I will explain exercise 10A. We have 10A and 10B. In 10A, we will deal with drawing cubes by deconstruction using addition and subtraction. So, we basically will start with the cube that you already know. Then we will add or remove parts of it. And in this method, form some kind of an object, a design. This method is very much used in design when you are sketching, freehand sketching. So you don't have time to use the highly accurate methods that we studied with the measurements and this. So you don't have always time to use those. Sometimes you need to be able to draw something very fast, to understand your design. So this method is very useful in this respect. So here we don't have any measurements to use, any specific measurements, but basically a method of how to draw fast, starting with the simple objects, cubes, okay? Besides, any object you draw in real life, you cannot draw straight away like with all details. Any object you draw, you have to first draw it as a cube or as a rectangular shape in perspective, and then slowly add details to it. Okay, this is the correct way of drawing. You cannot, for example, draw curves before you draw the rectangular object, like for example, the circle. Okay, you cannot draw a circle straight away in perspective. You have to draw first the square in perspective, then draw the circle, then other details, and so on. So this is the same idea. In both exercise 10A and 10B, we will cover different aspects of this technique. But both techniques that we will cover will involve starting with cubes or rectangles, and then moving on to develop objects. Now here, I will start with cube as the exercise should be. So I will draw a cube first, and then I will try to think of ways to add or subtract parts of it. Okay, and you will see, I will explain on the way how to do it. After I explain the technique, in the end I will talk about the homework. And it will be your design. Please do not copy what I draw here. Do not copy. Okay, this is just for explanation. If I want you to copy what I'm drawing, I will say it very clearly, okay? I will say it. And I will have a drawing here, and I will follow step by step, and then I will say to you, draw exactly this object. Here we don't have, okay? I am drawing here only to explain to you the technique. But when you draw, you will have to draw your own designs. Anyway, okay, this in the end I will explain again and exactly what you will need to do for the homework. Now, let us start with explaining what do I mean with starting with a cube and then removing or adding details to it to form some kind of an object. So let me draw a cube. We are drawing in a two-point perspective, okay? Two-point perspective. So we have a horizon line, like usual. Two points. I am guessing where is this located and where is this. Remember, in our first exercises we did that. Because here we do not have measurements. We are not using the measuring perspective methods, okay? This is more of a freehand sketching technique, as I said. So, I start with a cube, okay? Look at it. Does it look like a cube or not? if it looks too long or something is not right, repeat it, okay? Some students are still making a mistake when drawing cubes. These lines, do you see this line? This is a cube. These lines cannot be like this, okay? Or like this. They have to be straight. Be careful. Of course, most of you are doing good work, but some of you are very, very behind the rest of the students. So you need to catch up with the work and the quality of the work. Okay, now we have a cube. We look at it. Okay, it looks like a cube. Now we will apply addition and subtraction. So I will decide what could I possibly do with this cube. Okay, now, before we can add, for example, let's say if I want to add some details from here and from here and from here and do something here on the top, before I do that, there is a very useful method that you can use. For example, if I want to find where is the mid, for example, from here to here, where is the midpoint? Because this is in perspective, I can guess where it is. And from here to here has to be bigger than from here to here, considering. So I can draw it all by feeling, you know, by guess. But if you want a little bit more accuracy, and this is a very fast way to do, you already know when we used to draw the circles, how do we find the midpoint of this, for example, surface? We draw two diagonals. So if I want to draw two diagonals here, I know that this point is the middle of this. Now I can use this to continue. Also from here, this is, for example, the middle of this surface. Here from the back, I don't see this. Okay. Now what can I do? Okay. I know the middle here, so I can put a line from here to here, going to the vanishing point. Okay. Then I can add something. For example, I want to add an object from here. So from this point to the vanishing point. Now, how much I want to add, how much to be this, it's from my head, okay? We are not using measurements. I'm choosing. For example, does this distance look suitable for what I'm going to do? Okay, if not, change it. It is a fast drawing technique. This going to the vanishing point. This how to do it. Let me think. I'm making decisions now, okay? I'm making decisions immediately what to do. Okay. Okay, let's say, for example, that's too short. I want to lengthen it a little bit. So make it longer. Side, I want to add the same object. Now from this side, I will make it a little bit shorter than here, because this is closer to me, okay? This is farther away from me. Okay. Now, what can we do? Okay, I need the midpoint of this surface. This here. The midpoint of this surface. Okay. How much should we take? Okay, from here to here. I need this here, from here to here. To the vanishing point. Now, this part, I want to make it like this. From here, I want to do the same. Let's say I want to do the same. Let me see here how it goes to the vanishing point. Okay. The middle of this surface is this point, or from here, we can take to the vanishing point and find it out. Then from this here through the point to the vanishing point, for here, where is the midpoint? This. So, this down, from this here down, and we will not see the rest actually of the object. This should be with the dotted lines. Okay. Again, what else can we do with this object? What else can we do? A lot of things, actually. Let me try to do something on this surface. So, okay, where is the midpoint? Here is the midpoint of this surface. Okay. I need to find the midpoint of this surface now. So again, I will do diagonals. So here is the midpoint of this surface, and the midpoint of this surface here. Do you see how quickly by drawing diagonals on square surfaces you can find midpoints? Then you can again draw diagonals, find the midpoint of that surface, and so on. So if I want another midpoint to find here, I can do another diagonal. So this is very quick technique, okay, how to find certain points in the object without measuring too much if you're drawing a fast sketch. Okay, so we have this. Let me draw this kind of object here. This object, I want it to be, let's say, a hole, okay, a hole. So, how deep shall we make it? That's up to you, up to the whatever you are designing, okay? Let's say I'm happy with this. So this is a hole inside. Okay. What else can we do? Okay, let's do something on this surface. For example, let's open here like a door and then extract something from it. So as you can see, we started with a cube and we are deconstructing the cubes. So we are adding things to it and we are what? Removing things from it. We are removing parts, we are adding parts, okay? And we can form objects this way. Designs, new designs. Okay, we have diagonals here. This is the midpoint. This surface, again, I will draw diagonal. So this is the midpoint of this surface. This here is the midpoint of this surface. So we have these two points. We can connect. Okay. Then, I will not make it a hole. I will extrude this object out. Let me see. This should go to the vanishing point, of course. Do not forget the vanishing points, okay? Any line you draw should go to the vanishing points. It should go this way. Okay. How long I want to make, that's up to me. We are not restricted here by anything specific, only what design you want to make, okay? Let's say this is enough. Okay, like this. The vanishing point. Now, I don't want to leave this as a rectangular object. I don't want. I want to make some kind of a semicircle here. So, look at this surface here. You need to, for example, put diagonals. This is the midpoint. So we have here one point. From this here, a line that goes to the vanishing point. So you have 1 point, 2 point, 3 points. And I want to draw a circle inside. Here I want to do the same thing. So from this point, it should be here. The rest I can do freehand. As long as you have this point here, you should be able to draw this object. Okay. So, look how I started, okay? Like a rectangular object, I have to draw that first, even if I later on add curves, or circles, or semicircles, or whatever, okay? Now, this is not finished, we have to connect. Okay, so we have to connect this line here with this, we have to connect this with this. This is the you see this point with this point. This is the starting point of the radius, and the finish point of the radius is here. I'm drawing here a little bit fast. I'm just adding a new design elements, you know, like how do I want my design to look. So we had we constructed the main shape, and then I'm adding other details. Okay, every design have a lot of details, so I'm adding, for example, I don't like this here the way it is, I can add some thickness to it. Okay, so I'm using this red pen just to make it more clear. What is the final object? Here, what did we have? This here. So I'm putting with red everything that that is the object. The green lines are the construction lines. Okay. Then we look again. Is there anything else we want to add to the design? We can We can't. It depends. It depends on your decision. Like, for example, I can take also this surface here at the back, this surface, and again put diagonals, divide it in half, so to know the midpoint where it's located. Then maybe this surface here, this surface I will also divide it, so this is the midpoint, and this is the midpoint of this, if I need it. Then I can, what can we do? We can use this point and this point here to put it up and stop at this level here, the middle of this line, which is here. This will go to the vanishing point, to the vanishing point. Then, for example, let me see here. Oh, okay. Again, I'm starting with some kind of rectangular object. I don't want to keep it this way. I want to draw another kind of design. Okay, so again, where is the midpoint of this surface? Here. I can put this line up. So this point here. Then the middle of this surface, this point here, the middle of this surface, this point here. Then I can use that, okay, and this point here, this will go to the vanishing point. So this point with this point, again, I want to do something of this type. But not straight, this time we will make some kind of a curve here. And here the same, and here the same. Okay, now let me draw the final whatever I have here object with this pen so we can see it better. And so on, and so on, okay? So, we are adding or removing parts of the initial cube that we started off with. And we could end up with a design of some type, okay? Now, this, as you can see, it's not a, this is not a, like a, something, a design that you can recognize. It is abstract, okay? So when I look at it, I don't know what is this, okay? So this is an abstract object. So if you end up with abstract designs, which don't mean anything, okay? They don't have a meaning. That's okay. That's okay for this exercise, because the main point is to practice, to use addition and subtraction of cubes, of elements from the cubes, to learn how to draw. So for example, if in the future you're designing something and you are stuck on some kind of idea, you cannot get out, it's easy to take a cube or some kind of a rectangle and to deconstruct it, to use deconstruction and come up with new ideas. And in a fast way, as you can see, I'm not using any measurements, just my eye, okay? What I want to design, I put it here. The only thing that helped me is finding midpoints of surfaces. If I want to know the midpoint of this surface, I put diagonals, then again diagonals. So this is a very fast way. Actually, some of you students already use this in the other exercises when we divided the cube, when we used to study the division of the cube method. Some students already applied this, which is great, okay? Now, but here you need to apply it because you don't have any measurements and it's very difficult. I mean, it's not difficult if you're experienced, but to know, for example, where is the middle of a certain surface, you can quickly find it this way. Now, let me draw another object. Okay, the same way, we start with a cube. Okay. Will we have space? Okay. Let me draw the cube. Yep. I mean, I can delete it, but I don't prefer. I want to leave it a little bit. Okay. 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 So let us start with this cube. Another cube, okay? And we will do something of this type again, but another object, another. The result will be another kind, another design. So what can we do? Okay, let me extend this side here and this side, like we did here, but in a different way. So I will extend it and extend this side. How much, it's my decision, okay, depending on what design I make. This side, I will make it a little thinner because it's in perspective. So from here to here is less than from here to here, of course. Now, how much? You have to use your feelings, okay? Because here we don't have measurements. But when you look at it in the end, it has to look logical. Like if some of you will do it in a... you don't have a correct feeling how to draw in perspective still, it will not look so good, okay? So be careful. Okay, so let me take this to the vanishing point. This to the vanishing point. This here, from this line, just extend, and here extend, and this. Okay, and this will go down. Okay, now, I want to put a radius like this here and here, okay? But it will not go, shall we put it to go down all the way, or to stop here? If we wanted to stop in the middle, we can find the middle by putting two diagonals of this surface or this surface, and we will find the midpoint, and then we can do it like in this here exercise. Here, I want to make it a curve to start from here and end from here. So, I already have what I need. This point and this point. From here, I want to do the same. Now this here, when you put it down, it will be behind, so we will not see it, okay? From this perspective point. If you draw this here, you will see it, okay? If you draw it up here, you will see totally different things. Okay, let me... Let me delete this here. This should be with dotted lines because they're at the back. Okay? Okay. Now what can we do? What else? Okay, let me extend now. Let me find the middle of this surface. Okay. The middle of this surface is here, this point. Then let's find the middle of this surface again, diagonal, it's this point. And here, this and this will be this point. Okay. Now I will extend this piece out and this piece out. So let's say what. Let's see what we will come up with if we do it this way. So, we have already this line. much to extend, that's up to me, what I want to do. Let's make it up to here. This here also. Then from this point to the vanishing point. To the vanishing point. This should also go to the vanishing point. Okay. Okay. This here we extended it. This here also here, I want to extend it. Of course, these lines have to go to the vanishing point. From this line here, see where this ends. From this line, see what this line is going to be. Going to the vanishing point. From this point to the vanishing point. Okay. So, we extended this part here and this part here. Okay, now let us try to put some curves, okay? Some curves to our object. So, let me find the midpoint of this surface. It's here, this point. Then I need the midpoint of this surface. This point. I think this is enough. So, I need this point. Now, the midpoint of this. It's this point. So, if I take this to the vanishing point, this is the point I want. So, then from this point to the vanishing point. And this point to the vanishing point. Okay, so this is what I need here, this piece. And I can make my curvature. And of course, any curve you do, remember, you always have a line at the starting point and a line at the finishing point of this radius. Always you have this. Okay. What else can we do with this? We can add some additional design elements, like for example, okay. From here to here, where is the midpoint of this surface? This point, so this to the vanishing point. We know the midpoint of this line. If we want to do something else, then from this point to the vanishing point. Okay, and I can do something else, extend even more. Here, I want to do it in this way, from this point to this point, to look like this. Here we could extend something on this surface, extend or remove as you like. Let's put something up here also. From here to here, where is the midpoint again? We need to find it, this point. So if we put a line to going to the vanishing point, this point and this point. If I want to make it shorter, so the middle of this, again, where is the midpoint of this surface? This here, okay, this is the point. So, this point and this point, okay. This should go to the vanishing point. From here to the other vanishing point. This line to the vanishing point. Now, I want to make a curve, again like this, but from here to here, like this. Similar to what we did here. So, the midpoint of this surface, it's here. So, and this point going to the vanishing point, it's located here at the back, and goes down here. Now connecting this, this is here the middle, and this is the end here. We already have this drawn. Okay. So enough. You can, of course, continue. Like, for example, let's say we will make an opening in this part here, of this curve. For example, let's make something very quick from this part. We already know the middle of this line, which is this. So this point here. Okay, so I will, the midpoint of this is here, the midpoint of this is here. And I will make an opening that looks like this here. And this line here inside will go to the vanishing point. To the vanishing point. And this will be curved because this is a curve. And so on. So let me, with red pen, just you know, outline some of the major lines that we did, so you don't confuse it with the construction lines. Did we miss anything? No? Okay. this is enough. So, so we start what with a cube, and we start deconstructing it, adding, extruding, changing elements, removing elements, until you end up with a design that you like. Okay. Now, what do you need to do for your homework? Okay, be very careful. Be very careful. Let me take a pen. Okay, so the homework, okay? Homework. Each one of you must submit two Fabriano sheets. A3, as usual, landscape, okay? You must what? Put the border. I cannot believe that some of you still are not putting borders. I said all the drawings need to be clean and tidy. And when we say we need a border of specific measurements, it needs to be there. Some of you are drawing very fast and very dirty and not organized. So this is not good. Not good, okay? So border 2 by 2 centimeter. Also, some of you are not drawing with rulers. So the T-square, the rulers, you need to use them. How many times should I say? Some of you are drawing freehand, and I cannot believe that you think that freehand is okay. Okay? I am drawing here freehand because I cannot use the ruler on the board. But you must use it. You must have the paper. You must put tape here, okay? On the desk, you must put your T-square and the other ruler, so you can draw clean, straight lines, vertical and horizontal, and even at angles sometimes. So please, if I want a freehand drawing, I will tell you, draw it freehand. It is a sketch. This is not sketch. It is, the technique is used in sketching, but when you present me this drawing, I need it to be in a clean way, okay? I need to see the lines clear. Not freehand like how I'm doing, okay, on the board. This is just to explain to you the technique, not for you to copy. Okay, so homework. 2 A3 Fabrianos. Inside here, you must draw 3 cubes, and inside here, 3 cubes. So you have a horizon line, with 2 points, and then you draw 3 cubes. Three cubes of the same size, the same size. Here, the same, okay, horizon line, 2 points, and 3 cubes. Cubes must be the same size. Now, where you put them, like, you can put one of the cubes up here or down, or, you know, that's up to you, okay? Where you put them on the paper. They don't have to be in one row. Maybe I want to put above the horizon line. That's great, okay? I will also upload you many examples from student works, okay, previous student works. You will see many examples how the students did it, and I expect something similar. So, three cubes. And you have to deconstruct each one of them and make a design. Here I have two cubes, okay? You, in your paper, you need three. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six designs. Six. From where? From your head. Okay? Not these, okay? So I hope I don't have to repeat again and again and again, okay? So, not these. From your head, six drawings, six designs, but starting with cubes, the same size cubes. Now, what is the size of the cube? Well, I don't know. It depends on the size of the paper. How much space do you have? It's not a lot of space, so you need to make the size of the cube suitable for this space. And so that when you change the design, deconstruct the cube, so that you have enough space on the paper. So this is your decision, okay? You decide the size of the cubes. Okay. So this is it for now. So you have, every student has to submit me two papers for this exercise with six designs. I believe this is clear by now. Let's see if there is something else important to discuss. Yeah, that's it basically for this exercise. Okay, thank you for watching, and good luck with the exercise.